on a Monday afternoon. You would think this kind of thing would happen on Monday, right? 365-4100, if you have any reaction to what has happened, and we're standing by. If we get another report from our network, we'll be delighted to carry it. And if we get anything off the wire, we will give it to you the moment it crosses our United Press International wires here at WWDB. To recap for you, an unidentified blonde man who initially has been identified now as a young man from Evergreen, Colorado, by the name of Hinckley, fired 3 to 5 shots as President Reagan left a Washington hotel today. The White House says the president was not hit or hurt. That's the initial report, but now we understand that he was, in fact, hit in the chest and that others were wounded. And again, we are not going to speculate on what happened. We're going to wait for the information to either come from NBC News or to come from other sources that we have. You're on the air.
Stan.
Yes, sir.
You more or less would have...
Bleep, bleep, sorry. Bleep, bleep, sorry. Bleep, bleep, sorry. Bleep, bleep, sorry.
I'll tell you what, I'm not going to take any more calls because it's absolutely ludicrous. Normally, on a normal day, I would blame the last 2 or 3 calls on the full moon. But the last 2 or 3 calls, I don't believe are indicative of the average intelligent caller to this talk program or this radio station. And I'm not about to set myself up again for another idiot on the telephone. And we will just stand by here and we will do what we have to do, and we'll give you the information when it is forthcoming. And if you have nothing to say with reaction to the president being shot, then go back to your beer and your Pepsi Cola or whatever. And we will be delighted not to hear from you. We had a guest scheduled for today, but as I told you at the outset of the program, our guest, who is a member of the Board of Education, and that is Toby Ann Boonen, has very graciously accepted our invitation to join us on Friday, and she'll be with us on Friday afternoon.
WWDB.
'81 has been quite a year already. Ronald Reagan has become our 40th president. The hostages are hostages no more. And the Eagles made it to the Super Bowl. And there's a lot more waiting to happen. We'll be talking about that, whatever else happens, on the Bernie Herrmann Show Sundays through Thursdays at 8 p.m. Now just think, 4 hours to dissect the day's events, or whatever you like. It's you and me, Bernie Herrmann, Sundays through Thursdays from 8 to midnight, only here on WWDB, the talk station.
All right, we will have, of course, NBC News on the hour and the latest developments, and we will have extended coverage 7 minutes after the hour, so stay tuned for that. And as I have explained to you, the initial information that we have is that the president has been wounded in the chest. He has not undergone surgery, to the best of our knowledge. The information that we've been getting with regard to the president's wounds, he was not hit near the heart, but was hit evidently by a one bullet. That bullet may be lodged in the upper left chest area. And that, to be perfectly honest with you, ladies and gentlemen, is about as close as a person, I guess, could come with a handgun from a few feet away if they wanted to shoot the president in the heart. The information is that possibly 5 shots were fired by the assailant, and if that is true, that's an abnormally high number of shots to be fired and an abnormally high number of people to be wounded in an incident such as this. By simple virtue of past experience with regard to, let's say, the George Wallace shooting in the Baltimore parking lot of a shopping center, and the attempted assassination of President Ford out in California, in Sacramento, I believe, when he was in office. And again, we will have NBC News on the hour, and the White House has been reluctant to give us any confirmation of anything that has happened. We do know that Vice President Bush, who was in Texas at the time, or at least airborne at the time, is on his way back from Texas to Washington, D.C. We also know that The only person so far who has identified the wounding of the president is a close friend and top aide, Lynn Nofziger, who says that the president was struck in the left chest and is conscious in stable condition. As a matter of fact, as Betty Berneman mentioned to you, the one report that the president actually walked from the limousine into the hospital, which is good news. And if the president should undergo surgery, I'm sure that we'll get the information from either the hospital or from the White House. And you can understand that communication during a situation like this, as it was following the assassination of President Kennedy in Dallas, is basically out of control. Telephone lines and communications with networks between Washington and New York and between New York and Philadelphia are overloaded. We're not making any calls out because obviously the thing to do at this time on this program is to wait and get the information for you as best we can from our authoritative sources and pass it on to you. We'll try for another call, and we will hope that we can get more information to you momentarily. You're on the air?
Yes, ma'am. Would have been wonderful if today you could have raised your magic wand on gun control and take all the guns away from these nuts.
Okay, sir. Thank you very much for your call. 365-4100. We'll keep trying. You're on the air. Are you there?
Yes.
Go ahead.
Yeah, I would like to make a couple comments. I think that this should finally, this in the gun control law, you know, about the president almost being assassinated.
Bleep, bleep, sorry. Bleep, bleep, sorry. Bleep, bleep, sorry. Bleep.
Ninth inning of a tie ball game, 10-10. Howard Eskin.
John, are you watching that stupid baseball game again?
I'm rocking and a rolling, rocking and a reeling, bobber and bob, bob, bob. Let's go. Mary Lou, tried Peggy Sue, tried Betty Lou, but I knew she wouldn't do. Bob-a-ram, bob-bob, bob-a-ram, bob-a-ram. You got me rocking and a-rolling, rocking and a-reeling. Bob-a-ram, bob-bob, bob-bob-a-ram.
Bob-bob-bob-bob-bob-a-ram.
Bob-bob-bob-bob-bob-a-ram.
Bob-a-ram.
You got me rocking and a rolling, rocking and a reeling, bob-a-ram, bob-bob, bob-bob-a-ram.
Thank you.
Did I see you guys on a Crazy Eddie commercial? Huh? Almost. You know what? I want you to sing some more, but there are some people that would like to talk to you, believe it or not, on the telephone. So let's find out, okay? Mitch, push a button down, and I'll say, welcome to the Marriott. You're live on WWDB.
WW96DB, the talk station.
Thank you for holding on. You're on the radio.
Yes, hello. How are you?
Our contact number in Philadelphia, in the western suburbs, and in New Jersey, 365-4100.
WWDB.
365-4100.
WWDB.
365-4100.
I'm a little late in doing this, Bill, but I want to welcome you to our station. Hope you'll be happy here and stay for a long, long time. Bill Gallagher is our new newsman on at night with us. And we hope you'll pay him some mind. You'll be able to hear him every hour on the hour, every half hour on the half hour, right through the Bernie Herrmann program. Except tomorrow night, you won't, because we have a Big Five basketball doubleheader, and everybody's, Now, listen, these are important games right now, coming down to the end of the season. These teams are fighting for a spot in the NCAA playoffs. But to make a long story short, we'll have a short show tomorrow night. We usually get on somewhere between 10:30, 11 o'clock. If it's an overtime, sometimes a little later.